here at Sunset Trail Stables. Today, I'm going to show you how to correctly saddle your horse. Today, we're going to begin by talking about some of the important parts of our saddle. When we talk about our parts, we have over here, this is called the skirt of the saddle, and this is kind of the main structure of the saddle. We have our fender right here, and this is where your leg is going to rest when you are riding. We have our stirrup, which is a very, very important part. This is the cantle of the saddle, and this saddle is kind of an all-purpose ranch roper saddle. So this saddle is made to really hold in young riders. So our cantle on this saddle is a little more pronounced and sticks up a little bit taller. On, say, more of a trail saddle or just kind of a less kind of ranchy rope saddle, you might have it where the cantle is a little bit less pronounced and made to be a little bit more comfortable, more so than secure the rider into the saddle. Then we have our pommel, and our pommel right here, this is what I like to call kind of the shoulders of the saddle. Again, on this saddle, it's a little bit more pronounced because this saddle is really built to hold you in. Next is the saddle horn. Next, we'll talk about our girth, and I like to say that our girth is the most important part of our saddle. Our girth is what goes underneath the horse's belly. And it's what's gonna actually hold your saddle on. So I always say you don't wanna be on the horse with your saddle on if you don't have your girth done properly. That's a really, really, really important part. Next we have our off billet, and this is what is on the right side of the saddle, and it has these holes here that you're gonna adjust the girth depending on the size of your horse. Then we can look over here at the other side. This is gonna be called the latigo, and this is a really also important part. This is what connects our girth on the left side and how we adjust the tightness of our saddle. So there's some really important techniques with how we properly use the latigo, and we will get to that here in a little while. So first we're going to talk about our saddle pad, and this is one of the most important parts of our saddling and riding process. So I like to either use a nice thick felt or wool or neoprene pad. So this is a nice felt wool combo, and again you can see it's nice and thick. I like to make sure that you always check the bottom of your saddle pad before you put it on, because if your saddle pad is not clean, it can kind of feel like an itchy sweater, and that definitely would not feel good on your horse and could hinder your ride. When we talk about our saddle pad, we always saddle from the left side. So Scooter being a young horse, it's usually a good idea just to let our horse sniff our saddle pad a little bit. Some of our older horses that are more kind of been there, done that, you might not need to let them do this, but it's always a good thing. Just, you can see she's a little bit interested. Who wore this pad last? But so she seems pretty comfortable with it. So now again, I'm standing on her left side, and I'm just going to place it right up here on her body. Okay, so we want her saddle pad to be sitting kind of right up here on her withers, okay? We don't want our saddle pad to be too far back like this or way too far forward. We want, when we are putting our saddle, or when we put our saddle on, we want a little bit of pad in front of the saddle to make sure that we are really cushioning our horse. You can see this saddle pad has this little leather patch right here. Most saddle pads are gonna have a little leather patch like this. Okay, so next we're going to talk about how to put the saddle on the horse. Now, there's a couple different ways you can go about this, but we're, a lot of riders like to take and put your stirrup just over the saddle horn like this before you swing it on. Or if you're a little bit bigger and are more confident with getting the saddle on, then you can just swing it over. You wanna always, again, I'm gonna let Scooter just get a sniff of this so she can make sure that she's comfortable and ready for this saddle to go on her back. She might have a snack of it, but so then it's really important, you just want to make sure that you're not going to just let your stirrup just slam onto your horse's other side, because that can make them kind of uncomfortable. So I like to just do this swing. It's way easier than trying to deadlift the saddle over your head. So I like to just do a little swing. So I'm just going to go like this and gently set the saddle right up here on the horse's back. I'm going to do a quick little check and make sure that my saddle pad is all nice and straight, and I've got some room here. I'm gonna look here at the back. Might be just a little crooked. But now I'm pretty comfortable with how this looks, and I'm ready to move on to how we're gonna do our girth. Okay, so next we're gonna talk about how we do our girth, and you have to go over to the right side of your horse to do your girth. So we turned Scooter around so everybody could see how we do put the girth onto her latigo. I like to use a neoprene girth. These are really nice. They help prevent saddle sores, and they also help hold your saddle on a little bit better than just a, say, a rope girth. So this is a neoprene girth. I like to, you can come and just put this on kind of like you would clip a belt on. Most girths have these little rings here in the middle, and I like to check that these rings should be about in the middle of our horse's front legs. Okay, so again, you can see that this is just nice and centered here, kind of in her armpit area, and we're going to be ready to do our latigo on the other side. Then I'm going to pull my latigo down, and I'm just going to reach under her belly, and I'm going to pull my girth under. Okay, so now we're going to talk about the way that we do our latigo. Okay, this is really important and one of the kind of the most confusing things to new riders. So I'm going to start by making sure it's not twisted at all, and then I'm just going to pull my latigo down through the ring on my girth. Okay, then I'm going to come back up through the ring on my saddle. Again, making sure it's not twisted. This is kind of a hard part. So we're going to come back down here. And it's nice to leave this a little bit loose when you're starting. If you get it super tight, then it's going to be really, really hard to actually get the knot done correctly. So then I'm going to come back down through the ring on my girth. Okay. And then I'm going to do my knot. And the way to remember this knot is if you can remember 7-4-1, you can remember how to do the knot. So we're going to come into the left side like this on our ring on our saddle. And you can kind of see how this makes a 7 right here. Okay. That's just an easy way to remember, go into the left and make a 7. Then you can see here, this is going to make kind of a fancy 4. So we're just going to fold it over, again, making sure that we don't have any crazy twists or anything like that. So then we've made the fancy 4. We're going to come up, always around the ring again. And then our 1 is going to be just straight down like this. It should look like about like a necktie when you're done. Okay? So that's just our basic 7-4-1 knot. So one important thing that we like to talk about before we actually hop on our horse, we like to make sure that our girth is the correct tightness. So what my good rule of thumb here is that we like to be able to fit a couple fingers underneath our girth and barely be able to pull back. So this might be just a little bit loose, so I'm going to make it just slightly tighter. And I'll always check it again before I ride, because as your saddle settles and as your horse lets out some of their air, it usually is kind of loose, so it's always, always, always a good thing to check it again before you ride. But right now, I can fit just a couple fingers under here and just pull a little bit, and it's snug, it's gonna hold my saddle on, and it's not uncomfortably too tight for our horse. Okay, now that our horse is all saddled up, I'm going to talk to you about how to put the bridle on. This is something that's also sometimes kind of tricky for our young riders or new riders, so I'm gonna just kind of highlight some of the important steps that you need to remember when you're getting ready to put the bridle on. So I'm standing on the left side of my horse, that's always very important, and I've got my halter and lead rope on now. So this is what I use to tie up our horse with, and when you're just doing general groundwork. You never want to have the bridle on if you're tying your horse up or having your horse in the cross ties. That can cause a huge wreck and a bad, bad problems for your horse. So what I'm going to start with is I'm going to unbuckle her halter here, and I'm going to clip it around her neck. This is really important because even though I trust Scooter and I don't think that she's going to run away or decide to go back to her stall or maybe just dip out of the video, I just want to be able to have a hold of her just so I know that she's still secure. I like to put my reins just over my shoulder, just like this, and then I'm going to hold my bit in my hands like this, okay? So I like to keep my 4 fingers here and then hold my curb chain back with my thumb. So it's going to be nice and easy to pull up over her head. Scooter's ready for her bridle. And then I'm holding the crown piece, the top here, in my left hand. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to put this up to her mouth like this, and then my thumb, you can kind of wiggle it in the corner right in here. I'm going to just pull up, and then I'm going to put this just over her ears, and just do a check that this is nice and adjusted. I like to make sure that they don't have a crazy lump of hair or anything like this. Make sure their hair is pretty smoothed out. You can check either side. I like to make sure that my bit, she has just a couple wrinkles right here. You don't want it to be way, way, way too tight or hanging down where it could be clonking her teeth. So then I'm going to take off my halter around her neck, and I'm just going to hang this up for storage. And I've got my reins here. I'm gonna hold my reins just like I would a lead rope. And now I'm ready to ride my horse.